Welcome to this intro video where I'm going to talk about my new book, The Call of Jesus. I'm going to talk about the new video series I will make. Together with my new book, The Call of Jesus, I will do a new video for every chapter in the book, where I'm going to share a little from the chapter and help you to obey the call Jesus have given you. The new book, The Call of Jesus, is 26 chapters. So beside this intro video, I will come out with 26 new videos, one every second or third day. And I truly believe that this can not only transform your life, but also many people around you. Yes, when we understand that we don't need to stand on a platform in Africa or stand in a church behind a pulpit to bear fruit, it will change everything. Yes, you need to understand that your home is your church. Your kitchen is your platform. Your bathtub is where you can baptize people to Christ. And so on and so on. Our life, everyday life, is where we should bear fruit. The harvest is ready, but the workers are few. Or the workers don't understand this. The world are getting crazy right now. The world are getting shaken right now. We have the coronavirus, we have new laws, we have conspiracy theories, we have fake news, we have fear, fear, fear. What is happening right now? What is the truth about all of this? How will all of this end? Yeah, there's so many questions right now. And it's sure that the world are never going to be the same again. The world is changing. And so is the church. The church as we know it, as we have it now, will not be there in the future. The church needs to change. But God is still in control. And one thing is for sure, that Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And the answer is that you and me and everyone else find Him. That we really start to be serious about our life with Him. That we start to obey Him and the call He has given us. Do you know what? This is a very excited time at the same time. It's a very excited time to live in. Why? People are getting shaken. That is correct. The Christians are getting shaken. That is correct, but that is good. Why? Because then we find out where we truly are. We find out where we have our hope. Do we have our hope in Him, or do we have our hope in the government? Do we have our hope in our health? Do we have our hope in our system? What are we building on? Many places right now, the laws are being changed. So even right now, many churches have to close down. They cannot have the big gathering anymore. So they have to come and meet in small groups. When I hear that, I can just think, whoa, this can only be good. Why? Because the harvest is ready and it's time for us to wake up. It's time for us to start to live the life Jesus has calling us to. Some years ago, I wrote two books. One of them is this book, The Last Reformation. It was about the church and how we as the church need a reformation. That we need to come out of the church system. We need to come back to the life we read about in the book of Acts. And the book, The Last Reformation, is at the same time our testimony, my testimony, how I came out of it and how I start to see amazing fruit. I have a quote in the book, The Last Reformation, and that is that Christianity started in Israel as a movement of believers who was led by the Holy Spirit, healing the sick, casting out demons. It started as a body, a living body, the body of Christ. Then it came to Greece and became a philosophy. Then it came to Rome and became an institution. Then it came to the rest of Europe and became a culture. And then it came to America and became a business, an enterprise. So it started as a body and became a business. But if you make a business out of a body, is that not prostitution? And this is what we have done. We have prostituted the body of Christ. We have come so far away from what Jesus wanted it to be. And in this book, The Last Reformation, I talk about the house church, that we need to come back to the simple, powerful life we read about in the book of Acts. Away from the mega churches, back to the simple, but the real and the powerful things where people was meeting in the homes. Because the mega churches cannot stand when persecution is hitting. The mega church, the church as we know, is not suitable for the future. And we see it already now with the virus, that many laws are being changed, many things are happening, and many churches need to shut down. So the Last Reformation is a call, it's about the church and a call for the Reformation. It's about that we need a reformation of the church. I wrote another book called Christian, Disciple or Slave. This is not so much about the church, but this is about what a disciple is, about what it costs to follow Christ. And that we, if we want to follow Him, we need to deny ourselves and take up our cross for us to be able to follow Him. That we need to be born again. It is not enough to have faith in God. It's not enough to come in a church. It's not enough to read the Bible. We need to be born again and we need to obey Jesus. We need to follow Him. In this book, I talked about how Jesus never used the word Christian. It never came out of His mouth one time, but He used the word disciples. Disciples. And I talk about what a disciple is in this book, that a disciple is like an apprentice. And many people have been blessed by those two books, The Last Reformation and Christian Disciple Slave. But now I'm out with a new book, The Call of Jesus, where I'm taking it a step further, where we talk about what is it actually is Jesus have called us to. What is it He wants us to do? How is it He wants us to obey Him? What is Jesus' call for you? What is Jesus' call for me? And how do we obey Him? And what you see is that Jesus never called us to get a nice church building, invite people to come to us every Sunday, and there we will sit and wait for them coming and then share the gospel with them. He have never called us to do much of what we are doing in the churches today. I started writing this book 2.5 years ago, The Call of Jesus. But then so many things happen in our life. We start to see amazing fruit out of it. We start to be so busy. People got born again. We sent out teams. New house fellowship start. We saw thousands of people born again and start to follow Christ. And they have grown all over the world. And we have been so busy. But January last year, we suddenly experienced a great persecution in Denmark. It was crazy, and our foundation was shaken, like many of your foundations are being shaken right now. It was just in a different way I experienced it. Last year, January last year, we were suddenly all over the news. And we experienced so much persecution, so many government agencies came after us, and it was so surreal to stand in. It was like standing in an end time scenario. It was like reading a book from some of the other countries who experienced persecution, but now it happened to me. Now it was in our country. Now it was in Europe. And when all of those crazy things happened, like undercover journalists came and hidden cameras, lies, manipulation, threats, all over the news. Like I was almost on the news every day for 3 weeks in the newspapers. And so many more things happened at that time, and it ended up that we needed to leave Denmark. And we came to America, where we are now seeking asylum. And they have now changed the laws in Denmark, actually make it very difficult for me or for my friends there to obey what Jesus have called us to. But do you know what? God is still in control. And on the way here to America, I felt God spoke to me. I felt He said, Torben, you are a pioneer and I am training you. You are experiencing this now because you are going to help my church to be ready when this is going to happen to them. My church are not ready when persecution will come, and it will come to everyone. And therefore, I felt he said, Tom, therefore I've let you go through those things to help my church and to train them, to wake them up. Because what you experience now is going to come to the whole world. Whoa, how little did I know that it would go so fast. Like I got shaken that time, many is getting shaken right now. And you feel a little of it. And this is just the beginning. When me and my family came to America, we came with 8 suitcases. We left everything behind, our training center, our family, our friends. But when I landed in America, I felt God said, Tom, now is time to finish your book. I've been working on that book 2.5 years, as I said, but I haven't had time to really finish it. And now God said, now you need to take the time, you need to finish the book. And now it is here, together with the world that is getting crazy. Do you believe that is a coincidence? No way, no way. This book is here to prepare the church for the future. It is here to help us to come back to the simple life we have in Christ and to obey the call he has given all of us. The future is going to be very different than what it is now. It's a new time. It is a new beginning. God wants us to be ready for this future. He wants us to understand what his call is. It's time to start with the small groups. It's time to go back to the homes. It's time to come away from the big, fine, very expensive churches where people are sitting and falling in sleep. The churches, they're all going to die or compromise that day persecution is coming. We are all called to follow Jesus. We are all called to serve him. We are all called to do ministry. Not only a few. Not only a few pastors or a few leaders. We are now standing in front of a great, great harvest. A harvest we have never seen before. And I believe that is happening together with a great falling away. And I want to say, the great harvest we are going to see is not going to be one super evangelist, but it's going to come from all of us. When we, as his body, every member of his body, start to obey the call Jesus has given us. And I am so excited about this. As I said before, I will, together with this book, do one video for every chapter. That is 26 chapters, 26 videos. And I hope you are ready for it. I hope you are ready to get this book. You can get it on Amazon right now. Or you can order it through our website as a print or ebook. Get the book already. Read it together with this video series. And then together, let's start to obey the call Jesus has given us all. I want to say, if you don't have the money to buy the book, send an email and we can give you a code, because I want this book to come out to everyone. We need this book to come out. We need people to come back and obey the call Jesus has given us. The text on the back cover of the book is this. I want to read it for you. The word of Jesus still have the power to transform the world and set people free. Unfortunately, the problem we have seen over the last 2,000 years is that religion and the tradition of man have been slowly pulling us far away from the simple truth and ordinary call of Jesus. The call of Jesus by Torben Søndergaard is a forceful reminder of the simple yet powerful and transforming call that Jesus has given us all. Through Jesus' word in Luke chapter 10, Torben brings clarity and revelation to what it actually is Jesus called us to. He shows in a simple way how we can obey Jesus' call and experience the same fruit the church saw in the time of the early disciples. The harvest is ready, but the workers are few. This call, if you choose to obey it, will transform not only your life, but also the life of those around you. Jesus is calling you. Will you accept his call? Everyone out there, I hope you are ready to say yes to the call of Jesus. Share this video, share the news, and let us obey Jesus' call and see a revival we have never seen before. As I said before, this call, if you choose to obey it, if you choose to obey it, will transform not only your life, but also the life of those people around you. Jesus is calling you. Would you accept his call? See you next time. God bless you. Bye-bye.